We've got different camera angles and fucking all sorts in this video. You can tell it's going to be a posh one. So, fat shaming. It's a biggie. It gets talked about a lot. That F word gets thrown about a lot. I'm not on about fucking Gordon Ramsay's show. Yeah! By the way, just before we start, this isn't a sympathy card I'm throwing out. This is me just telling you exactly what's happened with me and my opinions on actual fat shaming. And it's very deep, but there is comedy. Trust me, it gets better. So anyway, fat shaming is it's a horrible thing to start off by saying. I don't think anybody should, whom is fat, should ever go through a self-deprivating, demotivating, an unjust way of living. I think it's wrong to fat shame someone. Not just saying that because I'm fat, you know. But let me take you back about 6 years now. Oof. Oof. To year seven of secondary school. Yeah, it's been that long. That's just all on me. Now I feel old. I used to get bullied for being fat a lot, and it's disgusting. I used to get bullied for being fat, I used to get picked on, I used to be pushed aside between the years of year 7 to about year 9, 10-ish, and then a lot of people used to go, oh, Dan's the funny guy, because that's all he could be. So year 7 to 9, I felt that I wasn't worth a single thing. You know, looking at it now, it's embarrassing, because year 7 to year 9 should be finding out who you want to be, what you want to be, sorry, not who you want to be. Well, yeah, I guess, who you want to be, what you want to be, make friends along the way. I think that's the best way I can put it. You know, you should be exploring, having fun, and you should be doing that all the way through, you know. Hey, I mean, that's life, isn't it? So in year 10 and 11, he's going to watch this back and go, fuck you, Dan. I can already see it now. So in year 10 and 11, I started connecting to a lot more people who didn't really take the piss, but kind of went along with it because I felt if they stepped out of line, maybe they'd get treated the same. So I've got a lot, Mr. Popular. I've got friends that understand where I'm coming from and have seen it happen. But there's one person who kind of showed us that it was all right, you know. And it's gonna get soppy for just 2 seconds, so bear with me. Me and Cam didn't talk a lot in school. We didn't, because we were two totally different ends of the spectrum. You had hot fat mess. I'm not gonna lie, in secondary school I was big, and it was really bad. If I've got a picture of me eating a sausage which someone took, I look fucking awful on it. Like, compared to now, you'll be like, fucking hell, Dan, you're skinny compared to then. Fat hot mess, and like fucking Danny Zugo. Do you know what I mean? So, but, you know, towards the end, Cam realised, so did I, really, the instigators, my unhappiness. And then Cam used to start talking to us, and you know what? He was the first person from that group that made me feel anything of worth, because no one had at that point. And then it stopped me from wanting to do things which I don't like discussing. But that man gave me hope. He was genuinely so nice. And I think that goes a long way, especially if you're going through something. It goes a long way. Do you know what I mean? And I think in that time, that was what I needed. So yeah, probably thinking now, with all the soppy stuff out the way, why do you make fun of yourself being fat? Well, to tell you the truth, it is quite amusing. You know, you can get some really good fat jokes, and I believe that, you know, own it. You know, if you're me, you made it. Do you know what I mean? If you're me, you've made being fat. Obviously, there's some medical conditions where you can't help it, and that's awful. I never like to be in that position ever, by the way, because it's fucking awful. But to the case of, like, where you've made it yourself, you know, you've had too many fucking digestives, right? You've made it, you own it. So if you can't own it, then you need to change it. And that's my plan. I'm going to change it. You know, I'm not allowed to drink any more carbonated drinks anymore. Which is a good start, because I used to drink, I mean, you can ask anybody in the house. I used to drink a fucking lot. I'm going to ring one of my good YouTube friends now, Josh, and I'm going to ask his opinion on me trying to lose weight.
Rant diggity dog, how's it going?
Oh yeah, Josh, it's going well. Please never call me that ever again.
I thought we were on that level, you know, with the...
Josh, we can't mention that. Anyway, I need to talk to you about something.
Yep, alright. What are you after?
Well, basically, I'm doing a fat shaming video. And basically, can you help me get fit?
What, you? The guy who based his channel off being fat wants my help to get fit. Are you recording this?
No, I never record you without your consent, Josh. That's been done before on YouTube. Right, so will you help me lose weight? Because I feel that, you know...
Right, Dan, I'm talking to you more of a friend here. Yes, you're a fat fuck. However... You know, you're cute, you're cuddly, you've got blue eyes.
Right, thanks for that,
Josh. Anyway, I've got to get off now, mate. I've got Sophie coming round this evening. Yes, Sophie Aspie.
Yeah. I'll catch you in a bit. But, I mean, with that message, though, it does become a fair point. There's a difference between knowing you need to make a change and actually not needing to make a change. I'd call myself body positive now. It's still not ideal, I know that. But from what I came from, as I say, it's not ideal. But I'm happy, you know, that's how I can take the piss out of myself, because I'm happy. It happens a lot more in women. You see a lot more women worry about what people think they look like. If you're fat, which, you know, coming from me, you know, it's probably worth trying to fix it, because in the end run, you're not trying to suit anybody, you're only going to suit yourself. By the way, I'm not fucking rake thin. I know it looks it from the top, but I'm not rake thin. There's some girls out there that go on a diet every couple of weeks because they've gained like some sort of rib cage back. You don't need a change for anybody. You're your own person. Fuck what anybody else thinks. It's not as simple as you shouldn't have to make yourself ill to satisfy someone. You shouldn't have to make yourself physically and look ill to make someone satisfied. If they don't love you for the exact way you are when you represent themselves to you, then they're not worth having. Anyway. To boost those body positivity vibes, I've got Mika.
Walks into the room, feels like a big balloon. I said, "Hey girls, you are beautiful. You take your skinny girl. What's in my braces. Water in a hole where the girls around and curves in all the right places. Big girls, you are beautiful. Big girls, you are beautiful. Big girls, you are beautiful. Big girls, you are beautiful.
You know, I know it was a little bit like a woof. Randy, are you okay? Video. I am okay. It's a video I've wanted to make for a long, long time. But I've never really knew how to kind of word the whole situation. And I just kind of wanted to tell you my experience, because I know there'll be people going through opposite effects, like anorexia, and I'd rather let you know how I felt than keep it here. Because we're like a family here. And I'd like to keep it like a family, so I'd rather be open and honest. Anyway, I hope you did enjoy. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.